So now we'll decompose the price effects into its two components
by Slutsky method.
We know that whenever the price changes, then it has two effects. So number one is called real income effect or the income effect of price change. That means whenever price of X falls, so the real income of the consumer rises and the demand for X will also rise if X is a normal commodity. So we call it, this is definitely negative. And the opposite case, if the commodity is a inferior commodity, what will see? Px will fall, that means M by Px will rise and consequently demand for X fall. So this is the positive.
This is, the symbol will be positive. That means both are moving in the same direction.
So, and another is what? Substitution effect. So if Px falls, that means Px by Py, that will also decline and consequently the demand for X will rise. So now we will do it in the Slutsky method. So if we just,
we can, it will be easier for us to explain or to understand if we use some hypothetical numbers.
For example, price of X equals to 10, price of Y equals to 12, and income of the consumer is 1x. So definitely the budget equation will be 10x plus 12y equals to 180. And if we draw the budget line, so horizontal intercept will be m by px, vertical intercept will be m by py, and slope will be px by py. So here it will be definitely 24, this will be 20, and I have done it approximately 24, 20, and slope will be definitely minus 5 by 6. To consume one additional unit of X, you have to sacrifice 5 by 6 units of Y. And initially, if we consider that at equilibrium, approximately this is the equilibrium on budget line I1, equilibrium point is E1, equilibrium consumption of X is X1 and Y1. So just for the sake of simplicity understanding, we consider that OX1 equals to 6, OY1 equals to 15. So total expenditure will also be 240. The total expenditure will be 240. So now we consider that price of X falls and new price vector is Px equals to 6, Py equals to 12 as usual. So for this, there will be, we get a new budget line, and here instead of 24 it will be 40. I am drawing it approximately. So this is the new budget line AB dash. The slope of the new budget line of 6 by 12 equals to minus 0.5. So right now the consumer has to sacrifice 0.5 units of X to consume one additional, to 0.5 units of Y to consume one additional unit of X. And here we will get a new equilibrium on higher indifference curve I2, the equilibrium consumption of X becomes OX2. So this is E1 and this is E2. So now we have to compare between E1 and E2. So why does the consumer move from E1 to E2? Because if we compare between E1 and E2, E2 indicates higher real income and E1 indicates lower real income, or to be precise, real income in terms of commodity X. Because in both cases, E1 and E2, the income of the consumer is same, but E2 is subject to lower price of X with the other things constant. That's why E2 is on flatter budget line AB dash. Second thing is that E1 indicates higher value of Px by Py. So value of slope in E1, slope of E1 is 5 by 6. And that means 0.833. And this indicates the lower value of Px by Py, that equals to 0.5. Now, if we want to decompose the price effect into its two components, so first we have to find out what is the substitution effect. That means, what is the change in consumer's choice due to change in relative price of X in terms of Y with the real income constant. So that means we have to bring the consumer back towards the previous level of real income. But we will consider this price ratio. So how is it possible? According to Hicks, Professor Hicks, real income is represented by the level of utility. But as per Slutsky, real income is represented by the equilibrium commodity basket. So that means after the price change at this new price, I will spare that much amount of money in the hand of the consumer, which will be exhausted if he purchases OX1 units of X and OY1 units of Y at this price vector. So mathematically, if I do, what should be that I will allow X with the consumer with only 6 plus 6 plus 12 into 15. That means 36 plus 180 equals to 216. So instead of 240, I will reduce his income by 24. So in graphically, how I will see, I will shift the budget line parallelly. So whenever given the prices, I reduce the money income, the budget line will start to shift parallelly leftward. But how long it will be continued? Unless it passes through the previous equilibrium point E1. So this is the new budget line CD after reducing the money income from the hand of the consumer. We have to remember one thing, that in this diagram it is very difficult to show the real income. So money income here works as the dummy of the real income. So we will get a new budget line CD, and definitely the consumer will find its equilibrium on higher indifference curve I1 dash. So this is I1 dash, and this is the new equilibrium consumption X, OX1 dash. And equilibrium consumption of Y is OY1 dash. So this is the new equilibrium point E1 dash of the consumer. So if we now compare between E1 and E1 dash, they are representing the same level of real income, because both, so this amount, wherever is amount of money as per this budget line AB,
or whatever is the amount of money as per the budget line CD, that will be exhausted if the consumer purchases OX1 units of X and OY1 units of Y. So E1 and E' you want as same level of real income. But E1 dash is subject to lower value of Px by Py. So as per E1 is on the steeper budget line, E1 dash is on the flatter budget line. So we can say that E1 dash indicates lower value of Px by Py. So compared to E1 and E1 dash, in E1 dash we have to sacrifice less amount of Y to get one additional unit of X. So consumer moves from E1 to E1 dash. So E1 indicates higher value of Px by Py and E1 dash indicates lower value of Px by Py. So movement from whenever consumer moves from E1 to E1 dash, just see the consumer is sacrificing the Y and increasing the consumption of X. So consumer substitutes Y by X. So that's why the movement from E1 dash to E1 to E1 dash, this X1 X1 dash is the increase in consumption of X due to the substitution effect. Now if we compare between E1 dash and E2. So both are representing same value of Px by Py. Because A, B dash and C D are parallel to each other, and we know that parallel budget lines represent same level of relative price of one commodity in terms of others. So same value of Px by Py. But E2 is on higher budget line and as well as higher indifference curve. So that indicates higher level of real income, which is represented by the higher level of money income. So here money income works as the dummy of the real income. So whenever consumer moves from E1 dash to E2, their consumption of X increases as well as the consumption of Y will also increase. So E1 indicates E1 dash lower real income, E2 higher real income. So whenever the consumer moves from E1 dash to E2, that is simply due to higher level of real income, which is represented by higher level of money income. So this movement is known as real income effect or the income effect of price change. So finally, what we see that so X1, X2, this is price effect. Say X1, X1 dash, this is the substitution effect, and X1 dash, X2 is the real income effect. So we can say here that price effect is the, because we see here X1, X1 dash plus X1 dash X2 equals to X1, X2. So we can say here that the price effect is the sum of substitution effect and the income effect of price change or the real income effect. So there is basic difference between Hicks and Slutsky. Slutsky method is more realistic compared to Hicks, because in Hicksian method the real income is represented by the level of utility. So level of utility is a psychological concept, but in case of Slutsky we can find the real income is represented by the initial equilibrium commodity basket, which is more realistic. And second thing we see that in case of Hicksian method of decomposition, there is no utility gain due to substitution effect. But in Slutsky method, we find that people definitely has some, the consumer definitely has some utility gain because of the substitution effect. So due to substitution effect here, we can see consumer moves to a higher level of satisfaction, which is represented by a higher indifference curve. So this is the basic, these are the basic differences between Hicks and Slutsky method.